Ebola case here in New York. Late today, word of a new and mandatory quarantine now for any high-risk passenger flying through New York or New Jersey. Tonight, the CDC retracing Dr. Craig Spencer's steps. He's in isolation now after going about his daily life through this city of 8.4 million. Spencer left West Africa on October 14th, landing in New York 1 week ago. The first symptom, fatigue, on Tuesday of this week. ABC's Lindsay Davis now with where he went here in New York, how he felt in these last 72 hours.
Tonight, decontamination teams arriving at Dr. Craig Spencer's New York apartment to cart away his possessions. City officials now tracing everyone he came into contact with since the moment he started feeling fatigued on Tuesday. We know he ate at a restaurant, the meatball shop, today closed with health inspectors on scene. He took a walk here on the High Line, a popular park winding through lower Manhattan. He stopped for coffee and then went home. Then on Wednesday, an outing with friends.
It was at this station that he then boarded one of the busiest trains, the L train, bound for Brooklyn.
Destination, a bowling alley called the Gutter. Health inspectors there today.
We came here to see if there was any reason to be concerned, if there was any exposures. There aren't any.
Spencer and his friends called it quits early that night, around 8:30.
He then took a car service over the river from Brooklyn back to his Manhattan apartment.
Very next morning, Spencer rushed to the hospital after reporting a 100.3 degree fever. Tonight, he's in isolation, his fiance and two friends in quarantine. New York's mayor urging the city not to worry.
There's no reason for New Yorkers to change their daily routine in any way.
And to prove it, the mayor himself riding the subway today.
On the streets of Brooklyn, residents are being handed this, the symptoms of Ebola, who's at risk and how you can get it. Meanwhile, here at Bellevue, Dr. Spencer is said to be in stable condition. David.
Lindsay, thank you. I want to get right to Dr. Richard Besser tonight. And Rich, we're all thinking about these doctors and nurses, the first responders who are now getting sick, helping us treat this. But in the meantime, on the flip side, a lot of people asking why this doctor didn't put himself in self-quarantine, even if he was feeling okay when he got back.
Yeah, I understand the question, but he was doing the right thing. Ebola, you can't spread unless you have symptoms. As soon as he had a symptom, he notified them and he got isolated.
In the meantime, Rich, right to that map, the airports where you travel back to America from West Africa, and the big change tonight for two of those airports.
This is a big change. JFK and Newark Airport, if you come into those airports and you're high risk, meaning you took care of a patient with Ebola, 21-day mandatory quarantine. I worry that this may discourage some people from going over to help.
All right, new development tonight. Rich Besser, thank you. And one more note on this, an image tonight. Nurse Nina Pham, the first person to contract Ebola here at home, walking out of that hospital Ebola-free. In Dallas, her fellow nurses cheering her on, and Pham's first stop, the Oval Office. A hug from President Obama, and tonight she says she is grateful for everyone's prayers.
I believe in the power of prayer because I know so many people all over the world have been praying for me.
She also says she is looking forward to reuniting with her dog, Bentley. And tonight, this image, the animal shelter worker in protective gear. Bentley not quite done with his quarantine, but looking well tonight.